you mentioned the protests. It's got to feel, it's got to feel good to see. For me, this moment in time, maybe you can speak to it, but for me, it feels different. It feels like the nation is united and sick and tired of people being marginalized based on their color or their sexual orientation or their gender. And it feels like this is different. Does it feel that way to you?
It does feel different. And I think though, what needs to happen if we really are interested in racial justice and gender justice, et cetera, justice for everyone, that then our policies have to follow protests, that public policy needs to change. And I think it's really incumbent upon each and every one of us. This is a wonderful opportunity to do a lot of soul searching, to do a lot of self-interrogation and ask ourselves how we've internalized various biases around race, around gender, and to really critically engage with ourselves and ask ourselves hard questions. I found myself following a guy who was posting a lot of things that like seemed politically and ideologically completely different from me. We met on a dating app, you know, that happens. And so I reached out to him this morning and I was like, I feel like we might be on different, you know, ideological spectrums, but I would love to talk to you about that and be find a way to be friends and not just because, oh, you've posted this thing that like, you know, he wrote posted this thing that's that suggested that structural racism wasn't real. And I was like, well, I think structural racism is real. But he seems like reasonable. And like, so I was like, let's talk about it. And I don't know if he's open to it or not, but I want to be able to have connections and conversations with people who don't always agree with me. And I think that's what we need more of in this country. So we'll see what happens. Yeah.